Hello friends, I'm Swagatika. Today in this video we are going to learn about how to work do animation by using Flash, Adobe Flash. In my previous video I explained what is Flash introduction and by using Flash how you can draw a picture, how to group the picture. All these things we learned in the previous video. In this video we are going to learn about animation. So let's start the video. Animation in Flash is like when we are writing any content in the form of image or drawing or text, then that content appear in the screen like in some sequence manner, either changing in the shape or color, all these things. So these are called as animation. So by animation we can create by changing the content in the frame by moving the object around the stage, either from left to right, from horizontal, top to bottom, or in the center position like that. We can change the direction, or we can change the color, or we can change the shapes. In the previous video, I explained what is a tint tuning and how to do all this detail I explained. In this video, we are going to learn about simple text shape tuning, how to do. Let's start. First, you have to open the Adobe Flash CS3. So for that we have to click here on the search bar, then Adobe Flash CS3 Professional. You have to click on this one, then the Adobe Flash window will appear on the screen. In that we have to select action script 3.0 in the create a new column, the first one. After clicking that one, then the Flash window will appear on the screen. Let it expand. See, I already explained this is the title bar which will describe about the name of the file and Adobe Flash Professional. The title it will display, then menu bar. These are the toolbar, all the tools. There are four to five sections, and here this is called as a property inspector, and these are the windows which window we are working. It will display on the right hand side. So for doing a simple text shape tween, we have to in the tint tweening every time we are used to convert the particular object into a symbol, but here without converting the shape to a without converting the shape we can create the animation by using shape tuning without converting the particular object into a symbol. Without converting a particular object to a symbol, we can create animation by using shape tuning. So let's start. So for that we have to write something on the screen, on the stage. This is my stage. So I will select the text tool here, and I'm going to write something here, hello. So I write here hello. Next, after writing the text, we can, this is the property inspector. If you want to change the color or shape or make it bold, you can do. Already it is bold. So for that we have to select, then this is the selection tool, already you know. Then you can make it bold, or you can make it italic, or you can make it change the size little more. If you want, you can make it little big. Next, we can change the color to any color. If you want, you can change any color. Then you can change the font size also, but this size is okay for me. You can, if you want, you can change the size. Then once this one over, then we have to click on this one window button, and in the windows just see, in the windows you have this align option. Already it is tick, means it will display here. If it is not there, then go to the windows and click on align. In the align option, just see the two stage one by one option is here. You just click on the two stage button, and then we have to click on horizontal center, because the it will move little further and move so up and down, so you can see that this is like a animation is forming. Then after clicking on the horizontal one, then I can right click on say vertical center. Then once this one done, then you have to click the close the align button. Then move the pointer to line number, frame number, any frame. Let's take I will select frame number 60. Then right click it and insert keyframe. So in the line number, this is the maximum from frame 1 to frame 60, it will show animation. Then after that, after inserting the keyframe, we have to select the frame number 1. Let's take I will select here frame number 1. This is my frame number 1. Then we have to click on modify option in the menu bar and click on break apart option. So break apart means it will break each letter into a separate box. Then in order to make it a symbol, we have to click on modify. Again, we have to click on break apart. So the letter become a symbol. Next. Once the letter becomes symbol, we have to go to frame number. Frame number, any frame between, let's take I will take here frame number 30, and here I will insert a blank keyframe so that it will break, it will show the breaking of letter. So here nothing is there. So here I will write another text which will convert from the frame number 1. When it will reach frame number 30, it will change the letter. So I will write here hello everybody, I wrote here, and this one I will change the color to something else color. Let's take, I will give this color. Oh, I have to select it first. Then I will change the color to, let's take yellow, is fine. Okay, then after this, again we have to click on this one and click on the Windows button and align. Again, we have to do the same thing, horizontal align, then vertical align. Okay, after horizontal and vertical align, we have to select the frame number 24 and then modify the break apart option. So here modify and break apart option, it will break each letter into a separate box. Again, I have to click so that it will make a sum symbol. The same thing what we did in frame number 1 and now frame number 30, and we have to click on frame number 60. Here also same thing you have to do. This one, for here also align, we can change the align, horizontal, then vertical. Okay, this is selected. Then after that we have to click on modify break apart. One time it will break, again we have to click on break apart, it will become a symbol. Now in frame number, in the property, in this, now just see there are three keyframes: frame number 1, frame number 30 and frame number 60. So we'll select any frame between 1 to 30. So let's take, I will select frame number 15, and here in the property panel, just see the twin one box is there. In that you have to click on the drop down menu and select shape, because you are going to make it shape twin. And same thing here in frame number 30 and 60, select any frame and click on shape. Now see, it became a shape twin. Once this all done, you have to click on control and test movie. Now just see, the shape of a particular one from frame number 1, when it is reaching in frame number 30, it's changing to another frame, another name. I think you I hope you understood this, how to create. In this video, we learned what is animation in Flash, how to do. And in the previous video, we learned the in tuning. In this video, we learned how to create a simple text shape tune. I hope this video will helpful for you. If you like the video, please subscribe my channel and you can visit my channel www.moboy.com. Thank you.